version history. Illustrator has now got version history. This is CC 2.22. And where can you find it? File and version history. That's the key thing. Version history has to be marked there. Also, you need to save the document to the cloud. So file and save as. Just going to go file and save as. And you can see the document there. Just save it. Every time you want to save anything, just go up here and save. So if I make a change, maybe reposition it, I can then go file and save. And that is saved to my version history, as well as, of course, the cloud. But it means that I can go back to it at any point. So you can just run through this. I can click there and you can see that change there. And it dates it. So 1655. 1653, I had it like that. 1652, I had it like that. And so on and so on. You can run through all your version history for your various paths. And it doesn't matter what you've got in the document. Whole load of changes. I could remove these and work with something else. I can save it and it will appear here. Window and version history. That's the panel. That's where it is, version history panel. So what's functionality have you got here? Well, you can see there's this downside. If you go down the side here, you've got this little mark option because it'll, down here, end of history. Anything you save here is only stored on the server for 30 days max. I haven't tested that, but I'm certain it's 30 days. It says 30 days and it'll be removed. But if you want to save it longer, you can just mark it here. Just go to this one or that one and you can see this little marker. So that one will be saved longer than 30 days. I can click this one. So again, click that one. And that also will have a little marker on it and it will be saved longer than 30 days. So I can give it a name, Sharp Vector Design, whatever. And you can see it's got that marker there and that will be saved. And you can click at any time and see the design. Now that doesn't restore it, just clicking on it, that doesn't restore it. What you need to do is go here, these little dots. And you've got a little dot there, so I say I decide that one. Click there and name this version. That doesn't mark it, it just names the version. And revert this version. So if I decide, you know what, I want that, revert to version. It takes a few seconds. And you will see that thing pop up there, but then you get back to your original design. And it's a great way of basically having an unlimited undo feature, which you can restore any of the ones you've done, or go through any of them and bring them back at any point. And that's it. That's version history, a great feature. Also in Photoshop as well, but Illustrator, just brilliant to have version history. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Thank you much.